What do you say to those in the chess federation who accuse you of being too glamorous to be a serious chess player?
I would say that it's much easier to play chess without the burden of an Adam's apple.
Thank you. Thank you.
be playing my earlier games.
What on earth for?
Looking for weaknesses in my play.
And?
There aren't any. Beth Harmon.
Shit.
So the pretty girl has taste to go with her other gifts, huh? You make me sick, you know?
Thank you. I'd like to walk.
To the airport.
You're gonna miss the flight.
Sooner than that. And one of those possibilities is staring at you. More than they do.
Yes. This will do nicely.
The only unusual thing about her really is her sex. And even that's not unique, it is. Liev was expecting an easy win. And not at all. The 27 move thrashing Beth Harmon just gave him.
Middle game strategy.
I've read that one.
J.R. Capablanca, My Chess Career.
That one too.
Maya, Rook and Pawn Endings. I know. You've read it.
No. But I have my own copy upstairs.
Get me through time. Do you have a minute?
Depends. Will you put me on the cover?
Finish all this and sleep at the same time.
You have to sleep. It's what keeps you pretty.
Who cares if I'm pretty if I fail my finals?
Oh, okay, you've got this so completely backwards.
We should celebrate tonight, huh? Girls on the town?
I can't. I have to study.
About using note cards. Note cards look sloppy. We will know our information.
The other teams will use note cards.
And the other teams will lose.
Bye, girls. Rory, see you tonight.
Bye, Suki.
Man, what's that?
My notes.
Really?
I don't think Shakespeare knew himself this well.
Legal pads.
Got it.
Tons of pens.
Right.
Some number two pencils, three highlighters, an eraser, a staple remover, and a peachy folder.
You need three highlighters?
Yes.
Three?
Yes.
That's a very random number.
Three is not a random number.
No, but I mean, how did you get to the number three?
One dries up, one gets lost, I have one left.
You really thought this out?
Yes, I have.
What came first, chicken or the egg?
Can we get back to the list, please? Explain to me the political ramifications of the Marshall Plan.
Pick a card.
Got our first entry here. It's a pro for Harvard.
Oh, whoa, whoa, those are not the final official pro-con lists.
Why? What's wrong with them?
What, the lines are crooked. The printing's all sloppy. Harvard, Princeton, and Yale cannot see them looking like that.
They're not going to see our pro-con lists.
What if they subpoena them?
Then I'll roll them up in a ball and eat them.
What are you doing tonight?
Well, homework and then homework. And if I get all that done in time, some homework.
Hello.
I'm in here.
Wow, you beat me home by 2 minutes. And your nose is already in the books.
I can go from zero to studying in less than 60 seconds.
Very impressive.
I've read like, what, 300 books in my entire life and I'm already 16? Do you know how long it would take me to read 13 million books?
But honey, you don't have to read every one of them. Tuesdays with Maury, skip that. What is all this?
I found that if I focus too much on one subject, I start to get a little punchy. This way, when I hit Bolshevik Revolution Overload, I just shift over here and oh, hello, Anne Boleyn is going down. And then when that gets too depressing, it's right over to calculus.
Saving the party subject for last, huh?
The shifting back and forth seems to produce better results.
watching it?
What?
The meteor shower.
What meteor shower?
It was on the news. The BBC said there's some huge meteor shower tonight. I thought we could watch it together.
Logan, I have been in the library for the past 9 hours. I don't know anything about any meteor showers. I could use a regular shower, though.
I stayed up all night reading the class subscriptions over and over.
You do know that if you weren't so pretty, you would have gotten the crap kicked out of you every day of your life.
And a 760 math?
Those are damn good scores, little lady. Really amazing, top notch. Those are PSA terrific.
Followed by the optional express lunch, 12 to 2, which is all followed by the telecommunications orientation, internet ID distribution, parents reception, 11 to 1.
You memorized the schedule.
Yeah, she's not weird or anything. She has a good memory.
Well, I study, then study, then after a little study break, I study. Anyhow, the books. Are you seeing the books? Everything you would want to read is right here. Feel it. Feels good, right? Now smell it. Nothing smells like that.
Yale.
What about it?
Yale.
What do you mean?
Yale.
Stop saying Yale.
It has double the prose of the other two.
I wouldn't say double.
Triple over filthy, dirty Princeton.
Your magic flute, Amadeus. All this queen wants is a golden ticket to Yale.
You look like a firing squad.
More like a welcoming committee. It's the big day.
It's all the color of Yale, you see?
It's just what I need to perk me up. I couldn't sleep a wink.
We know. We heard you watching Gilmore Girls all night, again.
I am so a better fit for Yale than that Rory.
Very little Jay. You girls are all taken care of, courtesy of Flair Waldorf, SAT prep, and spa.
Are you serious?
If you're gonna sweat the test, it better not clog your pores.
This evening at my penthouse, you'll find personal tutors, hot stone massages, mani-pedis, and an amazing acupuncturist who specializes in mental acuity.
Guess that beats my dad's lasagna.
I'll flicker over some photos for you. Oh, it's upper classmen only. I'm sure you understand.
Do you remember when Dad gave me my first Yale sweatshirt? I don't think any piece of clothing has ever fit me more perfectly. Not to mention how adorable I found that bulldog. Remember when I asked you if I could get a bulldog? Good call, by the way, saying no.
And now the big day is finally here. Soon Nate and I'll be away at college. Him coming down to Yale, me going up to Dartmouth, Dad flying him for the Princeton game. I hope it doesn't make you feel old watching me grow up.
Eat up, Miss Blair. Your mom would want you to have a good breakfast.
Everyone knows that the only real Ivies are the Holy Trinity, Harvard, Yale, and Princeton.
I know you may find this hard to believe, but not everyone wants to go to Yale because not everyone wants to be Blair Waldorf.
Not everyone can be.
My God.
We'll celebrate your acceptance tonight at the opera with champagne at all intermission. We will be so drunk by the time someone dies, we will just laugh.
Stop along the way. I'm a destination, and if you refuse to attend, I'm gonna have to find a replacement. Girls, the waiting list.
2200. Fair.
It's 90th percentile.
Which means Nelly Yuki probably got 2300.
You don't even talk to her. Why do you care how she does?
Nelly Yuki has her sights set on Yale, too. What are the odds of them accepting two girls from Constance? And have you seen Nelly Yuki's extracurriculars? I need to kick her well-rounded ass.
And they say you've lost your edge.
Nelly Yuki must be destroyed.
Hi, Bea.
What are you doing here?
I'm in your room. Can we talk later?
Impressive.
Oh, it's not for me.
Like her older sister, Spencer's on the fast track to an Ivy League education.
I really do like the idea, Spence. I want to make sure you have time for the commitments you've already taken on. This class president thing, it's always been a big undertaking for you.
Do this.
Alexander Hamilton immigrated to the United States in 1772 from what Caribbean island?
Nevis. St. Croix.
Mona's got the quick draw, but one kills to Spencer. Next.
Insane. How many words do they expect you to learn in one night?
Stringent. Tough. Inflexible.
It's not like you're gonna actually use them.
Meretricious. I mean, it's not like you go to college and then you just start speaking a completely different language.
It's about getting into college. Meretricious, phony, flashy.
This document, which formalized the end of World War I, was originally known
as... Treaty of Versailles.
So what makes you so sure you're gonna win the competition? Oh, right, I forgot. It's in your DNA.
Allie, are you even going to take this test? I would really love to, but I have to study.
Thank you. Thank you.